understood legal advice from specialist personal injury lawyers. Melbourne Injury Lawyers, proudly supporting footy in the West, 8311 1888, and proud supporters of 88.9 Win FM. You're listening to the WRFL Match of the Day, thanks to Bridgestone Tyres, St Albans and Hoppers Crossing, proud sponsors of 88.9 Win FM. You're listening to the WRFL Match of the Day, thanks to Bridgestone Tyres, St Albans and Hoppers Crossing, proud sponsors of 88.9 Win FM.
We've always been driven.
And welcome back to the WRFL Match of the Day. We're here at Witten Oval for the Ballarat Football League, taking on the best of the Western Region Football League. So players are all out on the ground, finished their warm-ups, completed. I think last final instructions will be coming to the players as we speak. But back to our commentary team, Pepe Cavalieri, Andrew Wilson and Gary Turner.
Thank you, Troy, as the players after their final warm-ups, they come together, and now Western Region first making their way over to this grandstand side wing. And so we'll be doing a national anthem, I believe, eventually.
We are.
So they'll be
Western. Yeah, we will be, boys.
Yeah, Western Region now just getting the team photo done. Waiting for Tomsey to get front and centre, take the middle spot. He's sitting on the outside. At least
trying to stay out of it.
All this stuff will get back to him, boys.
Yeah, I know.
That's all right.
Come to Ballarat, boys, over.
Yeah.
So the stage is almost set. 4 minutes till the opening bounce. So what are your thoughts as we near the opening bounce, Willow? What's going to be the key?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. If once the players are lined up, if you could be upstanding, please. Once again, welcome everybody to the WorkSafe AFL Victoria Community Championships today between the Western Region Footy League and the Ballarat Football and Netball League. As I said, please be upstanding for the national anthem.
Just wait for the anthem to begin. All the players, umpires, all lined up.
Very nervous time there for the WRFL guys. They're definitely firing themselves up, and this should be the little bit of motivation they need, guys.
Sends tingles down your spine.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now the two captains for the toss of the coin, Steve Kennedy from Ballarat, Murray Boyd from the Western Region Footy League. Here we go. Kennedy to call. Western Region have won the toss and will kick with the wind into the first quarter.
Positive start.
Yeah, big toss to win
a good
that
start.
One.
It is a good one to win with the breeze going down. We spoke to Kev earlier. He mentioned it might have even extended out to a 4-5 goal advantage kicking that way. So it'll be an absolute key to get off to a good start here. But the Western Region Footy League, they were arm in arm. Ballarat League, hands side by side. Some people like to look at that as an omen of camaraderie or a lack of camaraderie, so we'll have to wait and see.
It changes all the time.
How things panned out, but you never know.
Yeah.
But certainly a tight-knit group of boys.
So who's your selection, Pepe?
Look, I'm going to go with the home side, I think, on the home track. I mean, obviously, I'm only guessing here, but if this was played up in Ballarat, it would have been played at Eureka Stadium, which would have been a similar sort of ground, very windy. So, you know, maybe the advantage wouldn't have been so much, but I think there's certainly, you know, you want to bounce back after a loss last year. The WRFL, they were beaten by the Eastern Footy League, so they'll be coming here wanting redemption in a way, Willow, I think.
Yeah, I'm going to stick with our boys as well in a 5-goal win. Obviously very key to the start of this game, obviously, to take advantage of the wind as they kick to the Geelong Road end. It's going to be a fantastic game as the players now just getting into their positions. So it should be underway in about a minute, which is going to be a fantastic afternoon here at Witten Oval. If you're at the ground, you listen through 88.9 or sound of the ground 90.1 for the uninterrupted, unbuffeted coverage of the broadcast this afternoon. So it's going to be absolutely huge game. It's great concept by AFL Victoria. All the competitions across the state are getting involved with it today. So we're looking forward to a fantastic match here.
Well, I'm sure plenty of people are around the place. We've got many games happening around the country. We've already seen Western Region Footy League, the under 19 side. They were too good for the Ballarat Football League.
95 point winners.
And we're underway. Here's the opening siren. Andrew Wilson, why don't you take us away?
No worries. Thanks, Peppy. Umpire throws it up. The rucks go at it. It's tapped out there by the Ballarat League. Handball gets to Finko, though, and he's wrapped up quickly. And oh, he's been pinged for holding the ball. The free kick is going to go to Sortino. No, sorry, it's going to Steve Kennedy, who pushes, kicks out wide towards the Doug Hawkins wing, finds Bucknell, but his ball is smothered now. It's gone to Miles for the Western Region away, and he's away down the outer side. Handball's over the top looking for Boyd, gets it, then the handball back to Miles, but it's well picked up there by Matty Dean. He gives it back to Boyd. They go inside 50 for the first opportunity. So Shea should have kept his hands out. He would have, could have taken the mark and had a shot for goal, but now the ball's been batted outside 50 by the Ballarat League. Dean's got it now. He's got plenty of time. Now kicks long to the top of the square, looking for Boyd, the captain. He's taken the first mark, and he's going to kick from about 15 metres out directly in front. Good start there by the Western Region Football League.
Certainly, and isolating him down in that forward square, Willow. Yeah. That's going to be important. He's a big man, Murray Boyd.
So Boyd coming in now. Should get the opening goal of the afternoon. And he has. It's the first goal on the board for the Western Region Football League. They lead by that one kick, 6 points to zero, and it's just over 1 minute gone in the opening quarter.
Perfect start for the Western Region Footy League. Always important to get off to a positive start. And they lead by that solitary goal, a minute and a half in.
Good ball movement there by the West. Matty Dean had plenty of time outside that 50 arc and was able to use that time and actually beautiful pass deep to the square with Boyd able to take the mark.
Absolutely, they go at it again. Sortino or Armstrong West, and they both got hands to it. It comes out the back in the long sleeves there.
Free kick to Miles.
But it's going to be a free kick. It's going to go the way of Reece Miles. Hoppers crossing player who's been in some good form early in the season. His side sitting atop the Division 1 table. Goes back across, now a hand pass to Bench, dances around an opponent now, pushed off it as he kicked, it wasn't great, just fell short of his teammate there in Matt Dean. Hand pass out the back, now it ends up with Quick, pumps it inside the 50, contest at the front of the pack there was Vols for Ballarat. Now the kick to centre-half back, Banner was there underneath it, he was brought down in the tackle. Hand pass out, now Western Region with it, the hand pass found Bench, gave it over the top again. To Graham, he pumped it inside the 50. At the back though, composed for Ballarat was Buckwell. He got the kick out wide. It wasn't overly accurate, but it's seen over the boundary line.
James Perkins doesn't look too good down there in the forward line at the moment. He looked like he might have caught one in the belly or something. He just seems to be winded.
Let's hope he isn't.
They just to really struggle to chase the Ballarat player out of that back 50.
Banner seen over the boundary line there by Magna Bosco. So we'll have another throw in just outside the 50, left half forward flank for Western Region. Their lead is a goal after 3.5 minutes. They go at it again. It was knocked down by Sortino. Fell towards the 50 arc. Now the hand pass out the back, popped to the top of the goal square. Oh, flying at it from behind there was O'Shea. He did well to force the halved contest. Ballarat trying to clear it out. Jared Graham, the little fella. Hand pass released his teammate. The kick was looking for touch, but it didn't find it. Now Western Region can work it around. Ends up in the hands now. Prismal kick to the top of the goal square. Over the back. And an easy goal there. Chase Perkins just strolls in and kicks goal number two for the home side. And they lead by 12 after 4 minutes.
Now it's good to see Gary Turner's eating his own body weight in hot dogs and cakes. Smackers, congratulations on that under 19 win, mate. That was sensational.
Thanks, boys. Yeah, the first quarter set us up, didn't it? 10 goals, too. They were on fire. So hopefully, the way the seniors are going at the moment, two quick goals. So hopefully, things are looking good.
I'll take it back about Jace Perkins being winded.
Yep. Ball's back in the middle. 2-goal lead to the Western Region Football League. Armstrong Western gets the hit out. And it's tapped forward. He does a good follow-up there by Armstrong Weston. Kept the ball going forward for his team. The ball's at centre-half forward for the West. And the umpire will come in and ball it up. So nearly 5 minutes gone, opening quarter. 2-goal lead. Goals to Perkins and Boyd. As the umpire throws up now. Another hit out there to Armstrong Weston. Tim Jenkins taps forward, but it's picked up by Kennedy from Ballarat. And he's wrapped up. And he's been pinged for holding the ball. A bit unlucky there, I thought.
Pie said he dragged it in.
So the free kick's going to go to Andrew Panay. It's about 60 from goal. Got the wind behind him, but I think distance. There goes the pass. That's a poor kick.
Got numbers back. Yeah.
Chopped off there by Jared Graham. Gives the handball and a short kick there. That found tongue for Ballarat at centre half back.
That's courageous there from Graham, going back at the flight.
Tongue goes out wide to the Dougie Hawkins wing. Free kick's been picked out. Still with Ballarat. It's there at left half, right half back. There's not many options. It goes further down the line. But it's chopped off by Maddie Ryan. Gets their handball away. Kicks it square, finds Maddie Dean. Handball's back inside to Langlands, running through the middle of Witten Oval. Now the kick over the tops, looking for Perkins. He's got Jenkins in support. And Perkins doesn't need, runs inside 50, snaps around the body. Doesn't even go close, but it's good, not a bad kick in the end. It's going to be a throw-in in the right forward pocket for the Western Region Football League.
I think you're right there, Kev. He's just gone down on his hunches again, mate, after that contest. So whether he's got the wind taken out of him, he's still trying to suck it in there.
Kicking goals makes you feel better though, doesn't it, Smackers?
It does.
Up they go, the back of the pack reaching over the top. Perkins had it though. Little toe poke, but Ballarat able to clear the danger zone. And that was well worked. Taking the mark at right half back. Alec DePapa pokes one short. Finds Hind. Goes backwards again. So they're just playing around with it. Left half back flank, Hines going to get it again. Now wheels onto his right. Corralled there though by Finko. Hand pass back, that's a good kick. Oh, just hung in the air for too long and Graham comes across and fists it out of play right in front of our commentary position here.
I think that's why they're chipping it around, boys. They've got Horbury and Hind, two blokes behind the play, so they've just got to chip it around and wait for the right option there.
Fairly defensive Smackers, isn't it?
Too, yeah, Kev. It's not that strong a breeze.
Ball back into play. Double-handed down by the Ballarat ruckman, and
Jenkins.
It comes the way too easy there by Jenkins. He pops it up. Perkins with the sit at the back. Used his body well. No free kick paid. Laser tackle. Ballarat under siege in the last line of defence, and a hand pass rushes it through for a minor score.
Done really well then at ground level. They'd probably need another crummer down there.
So it's 2-1 to nothing after nearly 8 minutes of the first. And that's a beautiful kick out wide by Ballarat, and leading up strongly there was Andrew Pitts, and he took the mark. Not much now to go to.
Been held up again though, haven't they?
Yep.
Just hangs back.
Just the numbers that the Western Region get into the contest. They're just they're flooding them.
Hind took the mark. Short, and that was a beautiful pass spotted up. DePapa again, it's a strong presence.
Somewhere he's list a couple of years back.
A little uncertain.
He
tries to take on his man and runs out of play, and that is
nearly deliberate.
Actually, that is deliberate.
Yeah.
He had no option, and he just decided to run himself over the boundary line.
No confidence just to go bomb it long. It's the only get out kick, you got to do it.
Armstrong Western now and Sortini go at it. Through the middle of the ground, they worked it well. Ballarat, Jared Graham on the outside receives the hand pass. Now it comes out to Kennedy. Gives it off now to Hine, kicks inside the 50. Cupido just reached it, went over the top of his head. Hand pass back, he gets it back.
Tackle.
Gives the hand pass away. They still find some space. The shot at goal from 40 metres out. It's going to come up short, but flying in from the side. And no, it wasn't paid. I thought it was paid in the goal square there to Lucas Anderson, I believe, but the umpire said no.
Yeah, he said it's touched off the boot.
And so we'll have a ball up in the goal square. Ballarat trying to get their first of the day, but that's a
free kick.
Defense. Yep. No.
The ball's got to hit the ground before you can tap it through, boys.
Yep.
That's what he's been pinged for here.
So it's going to be a free kick to Ballarat in
Damien
the goal
Cupido
square.
Walking up, that's mine.
He wants it.
I've kicked 20 for Bacchus Marsh in the last 2 weeks. I'll have this one.
So the man who ran it out of bounds just a minute ago, one of Cupido's teammates at Bacchus Marsh, he just threads it through from point blank range, and that's a big goal for Ballarat. And they cut the margin to 7 points. We've gone 10 minutes of the opening quarter. It's 2-1, 13 to 1 straight six.
I think, Kev, what the Western Region will be looking at, their coaching staff here, is whether they go and man up Horbury and Hine, the two boys that created that run and link just then.
Yep.
They can't let two of them be on their own. So whether they throw someone else that's loose down here in the back line, which it looks like Brian Graham out on that other side.
Ball thrown back up the middle. It's Kennedy for Ballarat. Gets the handball away to Anderson. Goes out even wider to Hyde. Now the kick looking towards the 50. It's a bit of a floater. Mungrel doesn't help his teammates. Picked up there.
Too slow.
Free kick's been paid. Advantage paid. Too slow again. This time it was Giampolo that was run down. Now the ball is back in the middle with... There's a kick inside 50 now. Shea gathers on the half volley. These could have been ridden in the back. Umpire hasn't paid it. Picked up, well done by Panay. Gets the handball away to O'Shea. He's mugged instantly, but it's cleared now by Delahy for Ballarat. Goes over to Anderson. He's looking for a runner. Gives it back to Delahy. Handball back. Goes inside to Giampolo. Kick down the Dougie Hawkins wing. He's going to beat all players. He's going to have a throw in at right half forward for the Ballarat Football League.
And so just looking behind the play still, Hine's still running around on his own there, so that move hasn't been made as yet.
Timmy Quick looks like he's got the job on Cupido.
Throw in. Armstrong Western gets the hit out. And Kennedy for Ballarat sees it back over the boundary line again, so we'll have another throw in.
Smackers, you're surprised they're letting Kennedy off the chain? Reece Miles is running with him, but he's not running with him, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, at the moment, Kev, they're probably sorting each other out, and if one starts to get on top of the other, you'll probably see a more lockdown roll there.
So the two big men go at it again, right half forward for Ballarat. Ball came to ground. No one really gaining a clean possession. Umpire will probably try and come in and sort this out.
Looks like he's put moved Spatiri onto Bucknell.
Yeah, and actually they push little Joshy McDonald down into that forward pocket when the ball hits the ground here.
There they go again. Armstrong Weston got it down. Miles streaming through. Gets a long kick to centre half forward. Underneath it at the front of the pack there was Perkins. He couldn't take the mark. Great tackle there by Panay on his Ballarat opponent. And we have a stalemate. Centre half forward for Western Region, about 53 metres out from goal. Boy goes up. It's a strong tackle. Oh, Panay ran into his opponent, and now they've lost it to Ballarat. The kick out wide. It's a scrambling kick towards the boundary line. Tracking it to the line was Bolton. Keeps it in. And now a relieving hand pass backwards. And that's a dangerous kick. Sandwiched between three Western Region players was the Ballarat one, and now it comes the way. If Spatiri pokes one to centre half forward, that's a strong mark by Panay. Courageous with plenty of opponents around him.
Just found himself in a bit of space there, Kev, at centre half forward.
It's what he does best, young Panay. He marks well above his 5'4" or whatever he is. Yeah.
From long range, he's backing himself in from outside 50. It's not going to have the distance. It falls to the line at the back. Surely the Ballarat player will be paid the mark. He was in front.
Even then, if you didn't mark the ball, there was four Ballarat blokes and two Western Region boys there.
That's dangerous. Graham onto the ball. Gives the hand pass over the top. The kick towards goal, though. Across the face. And, well, dodged a bullet there, did Ballarat.
Castellino, he had a bit more time than what he thought then.
Gee, it was a poor kick, though. Tried to really drill it. And out of defence, so it's 2-2, 14 to 1, straight 6, an 8-point lead. About halfway through the first quarter here at Witten Oval. Western Region kicking with a bit of a breeze in the opening quarter. That kick out to the advantage there.
Hind again.
Hind.
Yep.
Racking him up across half back. Pokes one short. Taking the mark out in front is McAuliffe. It's a beautiful pass. Back inside to the corridor. Giampaolo takes the mark. Horsham export, Chris Giampaolo, actually. Good young player. Gives the hand pass back now. McAuliffe weaves his way through. Got a bit of contact. The kick wasn't great. High up and under towards the wing. Underneath it there. Laying a strong tackle again, Panay. Umpire will come and sort that one out too.
So 15 minutes gone, 8-point lead to the Western Region Football League. Tap one down there by the Ballarat League, but it's Boyd who crumbs it, gives it to Chris Graham, who just bangs it on his foot and hacks it forward towards the attacking 50 for the Western Region Football League. And the ball rolls out of bounds at the intersection of the boundary and the 50-metre line in the right forward pocket.
It's probably a good outcome there because we're outnumbered again. So we've still got that loose across there. This time it was big Ryan Hobbs.
So, umpires getting set to throw it back in. The Boyd in the ruck. Up against Sortino. Short throw in. It's picked up there by Dalahy for the Western Region. Gets it to Sortino. Handball, missed the target. Reece Miles almost had an opportunity to bang it through, but wrapped up quickly. Kennedy, she was strong there, got their handball away to Jared Graham. Now there's a clearing kick out for the Ballarat team, but it's picked up by Ferrari. He goes back to Sablich. Now he's running through the centre square, on his left boot, goes long, looking for Panay. But
bad option.
No, he's given away the free kick, Panay. And now they're away, the Ballarat League. Kick goes to the left half forward. Ferrari does the spoiling there on Pitson. But Pitson does well, gets their handball to Pring. Now the kick goes in an open 50. It's a foot race. Now you've got Tim Quick running after it. We've got a bit of help from Sablich, and Sablich gathers now on his right boot, squares it, but it's not a great kick. It's a turnover. And Andrew Pitson has taken the mark, and he'll kick from about 48 metres. He's going back here. He's going to take the shot. 48 metres, 45-degree angle.
Ignored a very good lead there from one of his teammates.
Toddy Finko, he could have hit him up through the corridor, and then he's turned it over again, Dave. He'd want to have those 2 minutes back again.
So Pitson goes for distance, hooks. It had a bit of a left to right on it. It's gone through for one behind. 16 minutes gone. 7-point lead to Western Region Football League.
Ferrari alone at right half back, takes the mark uncontested, gives the hand pass, and all of a sudden it's found its way to centre half forward. Underneath it, Perkins was dealt with by two Ballarat players, and he'll have a free kick. He's got plenty of players running back towards goal, but he chooses not to go for it.
He's backing himself from there with the win.
Well,
and he's a good kick, Jace.
He's one of our Kevies, ignored three of them.
I know. Mills was on for about 30 seconds there, I thought.
Valet stands the mark. Perkins, he'll kick from inside the centre square. Gives it a go. It's not bad. It's going to miss right, though. Swinging very late. And that's out on the full. So no score yet.
Steve Kennedy having a rest for Ballarat.
2-2 plays 1-1. As again, Nick Hine takes the mark. Just at the tip of the defensive goal square. Pokes one over the top. Whoa. Nearly came unstuck there. Giampaolo took the mark. And then poked one short again. So the Ballarat side has it. Just where the 50 intersects the boundary line. On the Doug Hawkins side of the ground. That kick to a contest is fisted over the boundary line. So 7 points the damage in favour of Western Region. We've gone 18 minutes.
They've still got the two loose there, Kev. Down in the back, the big fella there. Hobbs. Yeah.
And then the one that's just going to run to Chris Graham at the moment. He was loose there for a minute too.
So Boyd and Sortino to go in the ruck. No one got hands to it. Perkins was underneath it. Kick forward, though, out of the pack. Was quick. The mark is taken. In defence for Ballarat, Hobbs. They might have turned it over, though. With a bit of time, the kick towards full forward. There he is again, Perkins. Was he held onto?
He was
caught high.
Very
and
lucky.
He's going to be almost gifted one. He'll only kick from 10 out. He's going to choose to hook this one around on the left, I believe. And he kicks the goal. Beautifully executed.
Badly made advantage
of a free kick. His second, Jace Perkins. And it's 3-2, 20-1, 1-7.
I just think the composure going forward now, Kev, with those two blokes loose, they've probably just got to lower their eyes a bit and reward the bloke leading up at the football. We just seem to be bombing it in, and it's sitting into the Ballarat boys' hands here.
Little disappointed with their disposal into the forward line.
And decision-making under pressure at the moment.
Yeah, agree. Totally agree.
So 13 points the margin. Nearly 20 minutes gone. Umpire throws it up. Armstrong Weston gets the hit out. And now it's picked up there by Jared Gray. Gets the handball out. They're away here again, Ballarat. Little chipping ball. Not a great one, but the bounce is a fortune. The kick inside 50 now for Ballarat. Sits up. Handball now goes to Pring. He's tackled well, but now gets a little way to Jared Graham. Goes, squares it up, but it's chopped off there by Josh McDonald. And now they're away, the Western Region, as they clear out with the mark to Panai. Panai squares it back to Finko. He's at right half back. Another little short ball that finds Bench. Both sides really struggling to get the ball out of their defensive half so far. Kicked by Ferrari. So Armstrong Weston just reaches out with the mitt and takes a one-hander on the right in front of the interchange bench here at Witten Oval. Now he pumps it long, looking for a marking target, but there's no one home.
There it is again.
The ball is chopped off by Anderson. He goes back into the middle of Witten Oval. They're away here through Giampaolo. Has a bounce, handball's over the top, looking for Kennedy. Handball's out even wider. Finds Graham, now goes inside 50, looking for a mark, unable to do it. Picked up by Bench, handballs. Now Sablich goes way back with the handball to Matty Ryan, now goes out wider, looking for it's a dangerous kick, looking for the Langlands, but Sablich is there to help. Sablich clears, now handballs to Langlands. Runs out of half back, kicks long down the line to Dougie Hawkins win. Marker almost taken there by Spiteri. Now the ball goes inside to Miles. Gets back on his right foot. Now kicks inside 50, looking for Perkins. And he's taken the mark. About 40 out directly in front. Good ball movement there by the Western Region Footy League.
It was set up by Tommy Langlands then, wasn't it? He could have kicked down the line. He just held back. He looked inboard and away it went. It just changed the dynamics of which way the ball was coming into the forward line there.
That was a good bit of lead-up work there from the Western Region boys. It's good to tell you what's really noticeable is those three wise heads in the back line. Sablich, they've got some experience down there
Ryan.
In that back line. Yeah, Matty Ryan.
Won the medal this time last year, Kev, or earlier on.
Yep. A bit of experience down there. They're not panicking when the ball's coming in there.
So Perkins kicks on its way, but it's to the right, and it's through for one behind. So the margin now 14 points, 3-3, 21-1, 1-7.
Just at the moment, just with a couple of spares either side, it's just being played between the arcs. Who can be a bit smarter using the ball going forward?
You just might need someone maybe to come, like a Panai or a Reece Miles, to actually break a line to come bring the ball in.
Aubrey to do the kicking in for Ballarat. Side 14 points in arrears. Almost 23 going to the first. He kicks to right half back, left half back. It wasn't a great kick, and just floating in from the side was Tim Quick, and he's taken it just a step inside the 50 on the right half forward flank.
One of the vice captains of the Western Region Footy League side. Good compliment to Tim, who's been in the competition now, I think this is his third year.
Yep, if he aims for this left-hand goals, it should swing back in.
Nah. About to say the same thing, Gary.
That
one never started on the right line.
Jeez, they're frittering away some chances here.
Ballarat might learn something about this breeze. If they're smart, they'll know that for when they kick with it in the second. Out they come now. Horbury on the left. Has another poor kick out though. And Dean takes the mark. Just forward of the Doug Hawkins wing. Left half forward. Pokes one towards centre half forward. Leading up again is Perkins. Just into the perfect spot. And he hugs it to his chest and he'll go back from 45 right in front and try and kick his third, and he might have learnt something from
Gary. Hopefully he has.
He's had enough cracks at a pet. Yep. To be about his fifth shot at goal, I reckon.
Yep.
He's had a few.
I think that's where we could win the game here, Kev. Their back line's not overly tall. It's mainly their on-balls and forwards. So.
And let's be honest, Shea hasn't had an impact. I don't think he's taken the mark yet. He's kicked this one left-ish.
Pokes at this one. I don't think he quite committed to that. That's stuck out to the left.
He jabbed at that, didn't he?
He did. Wasn't a confident attempt. So that margin now 15 points. As we near quarter time here in this senior match. Corralled in the back half and now taking a couple of bounces. Oh, well done by Hyde, and a beautiful kick out. And he spots up McAuliffe, takes the mark. Moves it on quickly onto the left towards half forward. Cupido leads up beautifully, takes the mark. Barrel chested Cupido. He's got a player running back, Mitch Banner. Now he goes to it, but there's players all around him.
Well done, Ryan.
Fisted towards the boundary line. Armstrong Weston was there, as was Brian Graham. And it's seen over the boundary line. So we're about 25 around from goal. Ballarat's end, left forward pocket.
Really good there by Matty Ryan. He pushed back without giving a free kick and he held that front position well.
So they go at it again. Toss to the advantage of Ballarat, but the kick was cleared immediately, but it's going to come right back in. Nathan Horbury takes the mark. Pokes one short. Under pressure there was McAuliffe. And he's turned it over. Bench takes the mark. Right where the 50's painted on the ground. Right half back for Western Region, pokes one short, finds Spatiri. So they just kind of manufacture a way through out of defence. Leading by 15 points, close to quarter time. Now through the middle of the ground, that's a good option. It was well done. Matt Dean pokes one further across the ground, still inside the centre square. Left hand side though, Sablich takes the mark. Further again out wide. As they play the Dougie Hawkins wing now, Sablich offers something, hard running, dropped it, but then gathered again and kicked inside the 50. Gee, no free kick paid. No, it was a free kick paid.
Unrealistic.
Yep. Well, it was an unrealistic attempt from the Ballarat defender, and it's going to go the way now of Jeremy Mills in those bright orange boots, and surely you can kick a goal if you're wearing those.
He'd want to be standing out, but that was a better build-up from the Western Region. Then they were composed with it. They just waited for the right option, and then they bypassed the two boys that were loose for the Ballarat League, and that's what they got to do now.
Davey Sablich breaking that line. That was the key.
It was a patient build-up, and can Mills deliver? No, that's missed near side as well. So they're frittering away a few chances here, the home side. 3-5 now. It's been a while since they found the major opening. Ballarat 1-1-7.
Just trying something different now, Ballarat, with their kickouts. They're all huddled in the corridor here.
It's an old school approach.
Yep.
Kicking walls.
The kicking worked out well. They're away here now, Ballarat League, but they've almost blown that kick, the second kick, but it's come out to Pring. Get the handball inside to Hobbs. Goes over the top. Puts his teammate under pressure in Graham, but he's done well. His handball was worse, and now we're going to have a ball up. No,
he's
going to
get pinged.
The ball.
Harsh?
Yep, it was.
Free kick's going to Sortino. Gives the handball off to Horbury. And he gives the handball back to Hind. He's been pretty good in this opening quarter. Looks for Kennedy. He drops the mark, but he handballs it back to Hind now. He kicks along inside 50. There's 2-on-1 there. Well done by Sablich, held out his opponent, and the mark was taken there by Brian Graham, who goes to the switch outside to Tom Langlands.
Oh, Prismal's on. Prismal's on.
He goes long, looking for Prismal, takes the mark.
Jenkins now.
And he's got the man over the top with Jenkins, but he misses the target. Hind again. He now chips it back over the top. Finds Bucknell. Now they're coming back inboard now. Kick goes towards the inside 50, but it's chopped off there by Matty Ryan at left half back. Ryan goes back now, finds Brian Graham. in the left back pocket.
At 50.
50 now against Cupido, creeping over the mark.
And this way they've just got to be a bit patient here. Obviously now with Jared Graham behind the ball and Big Sortino wandering back there.
So Graham squares it to Quick. Now they attack the grandstand side here. Another short ball. Ball kick to Ferrari at his feet. Fortunately for the Western Region Football League, Tim Quick came back to help out. Handball's back to Ryan. He's got some time now. A little chippy ball over top finds Jenkins. Good play there by Matty Ryan. Good patience there. Tim Jenkins looks for options. Might have to go to bailout kick to Boyd. One down the line.
Down the line.
Clears Boyd. It's in the Perkins direction. Perkins is able to cause a contest.
Oh, that's deliberate.
The ball is gone. Out of bounds. And we'll have a throw in.
That's why you don't have an umpire's ticket.
That was deliberate, Kevin.
No, it was. It wasn't going any rules but out.
So we're at right half forward, throw in, just outside the 50 for Western Region. Paddled over the back, trying to get his hands on it for Ballarat. Was Buckwell, couldn't do so. They all pile in.
No, I was going to say, if he's consistent, he had to pay that.
Yep. Paying a lot of him today, haven't they?
It's gone against the youngster, Josh McDonald, pinned for holding the ball. Ballarat now can relieve some pressure.
Well,
short
15.
Pass from Tung. Wasn't paid the appropriate distance. And then Giampolo ran into his opponent. Ducked back, though. And that was good composure from Chris there. And he found Hobbs in the back line. He poked one over the top. Hind was there again. And now running up. That's a good mark. Taken by Notman. Pokes one over the top now. Sortino in a bit of space. Opts not to play on. Ducks one back again. Notman. Smothered though
good
off the boot.
Jenkins.
And they can work it through. Saplich was
kick.
Brought down. Is it going to be a free kick paid out of this?
Back.
Great work by Timmy Jenkins then. He's the smallest bloke on the ground. Kevin, he made him kick over him and got a hand on it.
How can you not kick over Tim?
That bloke just did.
Well, the switch was affected well to Ferrari. Just sort of lobs one over the top. Out in front of Perkins. He take the mark. He nearly did it. Bounced off his chest. And now it rolls over the line. Both players pretty happy to see it find the safety of the boundary. So we've done a full circle. We're back where we started. Right half forward for Western Region. 31 minutes gone now. Almost siren time, you'd think. Giampolo tracks it. But now the hand pass comes out the back. Pring. Kennedy. Well done. Good composure shown there from Anderson. Ducks around. Graham. Giampolo. Kennedy. Stuck on the boundary, back to Giampolo, tries to keep it in. He did not.
Good pressure there by Jeremy Mills.
So they just corralled them, and eventually they ran out of room, Ballarat. So we're right in front of our commentary position here at the Witten Oval. 3-5-23, plays 1-1-7. Up they go, out the back. Well done by Pring. Gives it over the top. Dallahy sold some candy and then poked one out wide. It wasn't his best effort. And again, track to the boundary line by Del Papa.
There's a few tired boys out there now. Their hands on their hips and that. So it's been a
long quarter.
Very long quarter. Bench there. Tried to ride the bump of Sortino. That didn't work out too well for him. And it's going to be a free kick. Graham moves it on. Now to Giampolo, called both those names a couple of times. That's a beautiful kick from Horbury, spotted up his teammate, and now running in, and can he take the goals on? McAuliffe to the top of the goal square. It's just punched through at the last line. So a chance goes begging for Ballarat. And that would have been a handy one to draw another goal closer on the brink of quarter time. That was a good kick out, moving it on quickly. Western Region, Graham thumps one long. That was a good kick. Unable to take the mark though is McDonald. And out the back, Ballarat can do well. Notman, that was not a good kick. Is that out on the full? It is. So it's going to come right back in again.
So the ball taken there by Chris Graham, squares it to Tom Langlands. He swings around on his right boot, bombs at the centre half forward looking for Boyd. But a spoil out the back by Hobbs,
free kick.
But he's given away the free kick, and Murray Boyd will have a shot from about 50 metres out directly in front. 33 minutes gone, opening quarter. It's only been a four-goal quarter, very, very long for some reason.
This is where we need a captain's goal, boys.
Started with the first goal of the match, did Murray Boyd.
He hasn't done a lot, really, to be honest. But no. Mind you, no one's dominated.
No.
Apart from probably Hine for Ballarat.
As Boyd comes in, kicks him just outside 50 as the siren sounds. But he's pushed that to the right. So at quarter time, the scores here at Witten Oval, Western Region Football League 3-6-24. Ballarat 1-2-8. Goal kickers for the Western Region Football League. Murray Boyd got the opening goal of the quarter. Jace Perkins with two. And for Ballarat Football League, Lane Buckwell got their only goal. Troy.
Fantastic first quarter there from the WRFL. Probably flitted away a little bit, but we'll be back with more of the action here at the Witten Oval for the Ballarat versus Western Region Football League just after this short break.
You're listening to the WRFL Match of the Day, thanks to Bridgestone Tyres, St Albans and Hoppers Crossing, proud sponsors of 88.9 Win FM. Whether you're looking for a new or used car, genuine parts and accessories, finance, maintenance or service, trust the Alan Mance team that's been kicking goals for 38 years. See alanmance.com.au for their latest offers. Alan Mance.
He said six shots at goal, so be interesting to see how this one pans out. Now, whether Graham's going to drop back into that to be the seventh bloke in the back line, but they seem to have got him on Hine.
Yeah. So obviously Hine now is pushed up onto a wing. He looks like they're running carry man.
Oh, he's their go-to boy. There's no doubt about that. Steve Kennedy hasn't had a lot of the ball, and he would have been the other one that I thought would have been their go-to man.
So it's a 16-point lead to Western Region as we get underway. Umpire picks out a free kick. Instantly it's going to go the way of the home side. Being held on to. Taking his time is
Spiteri.
Spiteri it was. He poked one short. Perkins leading up, takes the mark, still inside the centre square. About 80 metres out, pops one up, top of the goal square. Floating back, unable to take the mark. Ballarat trying to pursue it.
Oh,
no,
that's
one's poked out of boundary.
He's played it.
Is, yep. Deliberate out of bounds.
Geez, that was good carries there, Kev, with that kick. It didn't seem to fall short. He's got a good leg on him, Perkins.
Yeah, look, he's a good player, Jace Perkins. I mean, he topped the goal kicking in the Geelong Footy League, I think, last year, and played some footy here at the Witten Oval for the Bulldogs, and also was on the Werribee list for a couple of years as well.
Brian Graham runs around and drills it. What a perfect start for the Western Region side, and they take advantage of another free kick inside their forward 50. Graham delivers their fourth, and it's 4-6-1-2, and to kick that into the breeze to start the second is a massive blow.
The Ballarat coaching staff, they're probably at the moment looking at Jace Perkins, because one out, and that seems to be the way we're channeling the ball at the moment. He's been unstoppable there.
He's deceptively strong, to be honest, and deceptively sort of physically barrel-chested. He really has a really good presence at the footy.
You can just see the setup. We've got a four-man.
Ball back in the middle. Murray Boyd gets the hit out. Picked up by Miles. Handballs to no one in particular. We're going to have a...
Handballs? It's a throw.
Wasn't paid a throw, so it was a handball, Kev.
They don't play them at all anymore. You notice that? They don't care how you get rid of it, as long as you get rid of it.
So Boyd grabs it out of the ruck. Probably should have been ping-pong the ball, but he wasn't paid. So the ball goes, spills down the right half forward for Western Region Football League. Finko's there, handball's back. Gets it to Dean. Now Savlich has got it. Gets it to Brian Graham, the last goal kicker. He's got a running Savlich going past. Now his kick goes out wide towards the grandstand side of the ground. Finko's got some time, gathers. Kicks inside 50. Looking for a marking option, none there. Ball spills just outside the defensive 50 for Ballarat. Tim Jenkins all over it. Handballs it over to Mills. It goes back over the top to Brian Graham on his left boot, goes inside 50.
There he is again.
Lace out. Jace Perkins takes another mark, and he'll kick from about 40 on a, about a 45 degree angle.
He's just really got to hit the scoreboard here.
Yeah. Not the easiest pocket to be kicking from, though. Brian Graham kicked the last one from not dissimilar spot.
So Perkins got two goals, two this afternoon. Comes in now. Kicks on its way, keeps it low, bit of a right to left. It ended up being at the top of the goal square. The pack forms.
Free kick.
Free kick. He's been paid too high there.
Is it Penai?
I think it's going to Castellano, I think. Yep.
All those little blokes look the same. And Pepe.
And that'll be good with Eamesy there. It'll be wrapped because the little blokes have had an influence the first 3 minutes there. Jenkins, now Castellano. Mills is starting to get involved. So that's good positive news for the WRFL out.
Castellano comes in top of the goal square. Let's put it straight through the middle for his first of the afternoon. Western Region Football League's fifth as they lead now by 28 points, 5-6, 36 to 1-2-8. And we've gone about 4 minutes, second quarter.
And believe it or not, we've got a half-time score here from Division 3 Parkside, 9-3-57, Sanctuary Lakes 2-2-14.
Jeez, what time they start, Kev?
We start late here.
We start at 2:30 here, probably a bit after. So, would be a quarter behind it, easily.
So probably not what we expected to start the second quarter. Two early goals into the Breeze. And all of a sudden, Western Region out to a 28-point lead at the restart. Comes out the back. Langland's got a kick forward. Didn't go very far. Running past there was... Oh, it comes out the back, though. Oh, beautifully done by Western Region. They're going to run into an open goal here. Is it going to work out all right? It goes to the top of the square. Great at the score. Back, Perkins just strolls in and rams home another. And they've got 3 in 3 minutes to start quarter number two here. And it's 6-6-42 to 1-goal-2-8. And it was Spiteri who broke away at the 50-metre arc. And maybe they made a little bit too much work for themselves, but it ended up all right in the end, didn't it, Gary?
Yeah, it was. And we just mentioned, who needed a lift. Bench and Miles then just got it forward with quick hands out of that middle, and that's where the game's turned here with Big Murray board in the ruck getting first hands.
It's ball back in the middle. 34-point lead. Rucks go at it. Boyd wins the hit out, but sharked there by Horbury. He won a free kick. He has for too high. Yeah, Horbury get the clearance here for the Ballarat Football League. On his left boot, pumps it inside 50. Looking for Cooper Davis. Well done by Tim Quick at the back with the spoil. But smart play there by Giampolo, who roved it quickly and chipped it around the corner to Mikalef, who runs into an open goal and gets Ballarat Football League's second of the afternoon. So it's 2-2-14. Ballarat Football League to 6-6-42, Western Region Footy League.
Jeez, it was just a bit too easy there, but it was great front and centre from Giampolo, as you called out there, Willow, and he saw the loose player over the back, and quick reply there. The query I'm going to have here with Ballarat, Sortino hasn't had a change yet in the ruck, so if we can wear him down, it looks like he's the only the ruckman they've got on their list.
Another half-time score. Yarraville Sydney Eagles 5-7-37. Trail North Footscray 7-6-48.
Sortino got the tap from the restart in the middle of the ground, but it was won by Jenkins. He got the kick forward, but it was unable to hit a target. And Ballarat can reload from centre-half back. Offering a lead there is Tom Carey. He couldn't take the mark. It comes to ground now. Out the back, Kennedy. Gets it again. This is Daniel Kennedy. Kicks towards centre-half forward. They do well here at Ballarat, but they work it backwards. Bucknell had it. And now the kick is going to come inside 50. That's better from Ballarat, and if that's not a mark, it's surely a free kick.
It's nearly 50, I reckon.
It was Pring. A late spoil.
Good grab
on Nathan Pring, and instead he goes himself. He goes to centre it up. Might have been the best option. Oh, but the man who had it about 20 times in the first quarter, Nick Hind, went for the soccer off the ground, but it was a shank, and it's out on the full. So they dodge a bullet, Western Region there.
That spoil kept from Graham. That was an old-time spoil, wasn't it?
That was a Rick Kennedy one. Yeah. He was channeling Rick Kennedy from the 80s here at the Noval.
He wanted him to feel it. Out the back now. Western Region able to clear it. But it's going to come straight back in. Horbury to the top of the square. Floating in from the side, though, is Graham. It's Brian Graham. Just stuck in that left-back pocket. Beautiful kick, though. Spots up Murray Boyd. Pokes one short again. This time Matthew Ryan has it. And now the switch is affected. And they've got players out wide if they can get it to them. Not quite.
Yeah,
poked him through the midfield, though. That's a good mark by Finko. Short pass, Banshaw just stuck the mid out and able to hang on to it.
Here's a teammate's kick.
Yep.
Confident player, young Josh Bench.
So is Toddy Finko.
Bench now just takes his time now. Receives a handy little shepherd from Sablich and now kicks inside, well, at least towards the 50, not quite inside. We're about 65 out from goal. Here comes Finko charging through again. Didn't get much on the kick, though. It was partially smothered, so no mark paid, but Ballarat with a string of hand passes. That's a good smother, and it's going to come back inside 50, I believe. Jenkins kicks it. Oh, couldn't quite take the mark there. And Ballarat can relieve themselves. Graham, quick hands, did well and found Pitson. Ballarat trying but unable to find space on the wing, and it's going to go straight back to full forward. But only as far as Daniel Tung. He took the mark, and now Ballarat sweeping hand pass out wide. They got numbers charging forward. Kennedy wanted it. It goes to Graham. Kennedy wanted it again, this time to the top of the goal square. Front and centre there was Pring. He couldn't get his hands on it. He does now, though. Oh, it was a throw.
He's played a throw.
And a goal to Ballarat. It was a throw against Reece Prismal, who pleads his case to the umpire, but to no avail. And Ballarat have run in and kicked their third. So they hang in there.
Just a turnover across half forward here with Chris Graham. He had plenty more time. He just whacked it on his boot. There was an uncontested mark across half back, and then a rebound, and it's ended up with a goal. So he's got to get the pace of the game at the moment.
So that margin now trimmed to 22. 6-6 plays 3-2. We've gone at 9 minutes of the second. Graham receives the hand pass, gets it out to Dean. But they work it backwards. Free kick. It's going to be a push in the back. It's going to go the way of Dean. Gives the hand pass over the top. Ryan got the kick towards right half forward. It was well spotted for Miles. He's in an acre of space. Pokes one inside 50. Not able to take the mark. Following up, though, there was Miles. Kick towards the top of the goal square. Underneath it, trying but blocked out of it, was Panay. And Ballarat able to take the game. A potentially goal-saving mark. Finds the way now to Anderson. Just stuck in that right back pocket. Kicks towards centre wing. It was a good kick, and well done. Gee, that's a good mark from Mitch Banner. Flew over the pack. Is that going to be 50? Dean crept over the mark.
I thought he played on, though.
Yeah, he swinging around.
Oh, the umpire's got to call it, though, I suppose.
He's a left footer. He was always going to run around his left foot and kick that. So he went off the mark. He went off the mark himself, I thought. But
East West, Kev. East West.
Yeah.
Well, Mitch Banner.
North bloody south.
Man on the mark is about 47 from goal. If he can get the journey, it'll be three straight for Ballarat. From the paint at 50, this one drifts right as well. So it's been a trend down that end of the ground.
Hard end to score at, actually.
Very difficult. That wind is proving tough to read. So another one drifts right of centre. And it's 3-3-21. Half of Western Region's score. They're 6-6-42 after 10 and a half minutes.
Western Region with the kick in. They go straight down the middle. Looking for Perkins. He's able to take the mark. The handball there by Giampolo. Now it's come out wide to Anderson for Ballarat, who pops it to the square, and it's going to be punched through for one behind. So the last four scores go to the Ballarat, and this margin is cut back to 20 points, 6-6-42 to 3-4-22.
Spiteri marks from the kick in. Gives the hand pass over to Chris Graham. And now out wider to Matthew Ryan. Sends one high and wide up towards right half back. It hung in the air. Ballarat take the intercepting mark. Now it's back inside 50. Finding space is Pring in the left forward pocket. But the kick wasn't really to his advantage, and it skips out of play.
Yeah, it's just a bad kick there, wasn't it? That's a dead pocket, but good defensive work with the rest of the region there, setting up their zone.
So I feel like it's a fairly crucial point in the game. 20 just points the lead.
A few half-time scores. Newport 9-2-56, Sunshine Heights 8-5-53, so a beauty there. Braybrook 8-6-54, Laverton 5-4-34, and West Footscray 9-1-55, Auburn Vale 6-10-46.
Fisted down by Tom Carey.
Unfurled the reserves flag today there at West Footscray. They had named nine on their bench for their second, so they're up and about, the Roosters.
Secondary bounce inside 50, tapped out the back. Beautifully positioned there was Pring, and he curls one through for Ballarat. Wonderful goal.
Those things shouldn't happen. Obviously, the Western region had numbers at that contest because Ballarat had the two loose behind the play, so that was too easy a goal at a stoppage, especially when we had the numbers around it.
Anthony used to be filthy at that, for them to get such a soft one out of the back of a stoppage.
Well, he read the tap perfectly, did Nathan Pring, and then he delivered the blow. 6-6 plays 4-4.
Umpire throws it up. Archon Weston gets the hit out. Kennedy rows it for Ballarat, gets the handball to Horbury. Now they're going out wide there through Hind on his left boot, pumps it to left half forward, clears the pack. Good use of the body by Savage, and then a good fist away by Savage. And now the ball still in dispute. It's picked up by Chris Graham, handball's inside. Finds Prismal, goes back to Ryan. Now turns a little chip ball around the corner. The mark is taken out there by the Western Region Football League.
I'll just break it down here that Perkins have to push up for this kick down the line.
Yeah, he often does come up on the wing, it must have been.
So the kick went to Perkins, but he was unable to take the mark and was chopped off by Del Papa. But his kick was smothered, and then we'll have a throw in on the Dougie Hawkins wing.
Dougie was here earlier watching the under-19s.
Sorry, me, just at quarter time, still here.
Oh, he's still here?
Yeah,
okay, there. Good. Yeah, he's here watching the under-19s. He coaches Bacchus Marsh, of course, they're under 18 side.
Tossing now, Armstrong Weston again with the hit out. Ball in dispute. And we're going to have... No, ball still in play, Graham. Now we have a throw-in. So we're out 80 metres around from the Ballarat goal on the outer side here, the Dougie Hawkins wing. So the umpire comes to throw it back in. Sean Weston in front, gets another hit out. Kennedy from Ballarat gets the handball back, finds Hind, his first back, but good running handball there. Delahy comes back inside, pumps it long, looking for Cupido. Works his way to the front, and I think he's won a free kick. And he has free kick against Quick for in the back.
His name got that.
No advantage was paid there, so.
Playing with a lot more confidence with now, all, Ballarat.
With all due respect, he just fell over then.
Yeah, that's what I said, Kev. His name got that. If it had been you or I, it would have been play on.
So Kipido is going to come in and kick for his first goal for the afternoon. Ballarat have kicked the last three. The lead got out to 34 points at about 5 minute mark of the second quarter. This to bring the margin back to 8. So Kipido from about 30 metres out. Comes in. It's a high ball. I think he's got it. He has. That's Damien Cupido's first for the afternoon. It's the margin now back to 8 points. It is 5-4-34. Ballarat to the Western Region Football League 6-6-42. They've kicked the last four of the afternoon here.
I think the Western Region now have got to slow the game down and play tempo footy for a while, and just even for the next 1 or 2 minutes, and just chip the ball around, take a bit of time off, and reset here.
Because Ballarat did a little bit of that in the first quarter, didn't they? Just take the sting out of the game. Out of the middle, though. Tongue thumped one forward, running onto it there. It was McAuliffe. Tried to track it, but now it's out to the boundary line. So it'll be tossed back into play. Left half forward for Ballarat, playing with a lot more confidence now in the last 5 or 6 minutes of the game.
It's game on, isn't it?
Yeah, they've got to stop the bleeding Western Region. They've conceded four straight after kicking the first three of the quarter. They threatened to break the game open, and now they do through midfield. Taking the mark out on the lead was Tim Jenkins. Pokes one over the top. They got numbers running four to the footy. If he can bounce track up. It here. Oh, got a horrible bounce, did Josh McDonald. Then he was brought down in a tackle and a soccer out towards the boundary line, trying to keep it in. A couple of big men on the boundary. Oh, well done. That's some great stuff there from Thomas Carey. He did well. And now Pitson gives the hand pass over to Bolton. Kicks inside 50. Cupido on the lead, takes the mark.
They've lifted a notch, Ballarat.
Yeah, great work here by Big Carey to just keep the ball alive. His second, third efforts. The ball looked like going out there, but a bad bounce. Josh McDonald, we were away then.
Well, Damien Cupido, been plenty of talk about him in the last couple of days. A late inclusion to this side. Hasn't done a lot until the last few minutes. On the left from 50, that looks good if it holds its line. No. Just drifted to the right at the last moment, at the crucial moment. 5-5-35 now Ballarat. They are within 7 points. 6-6-42 after 18 minutes.
West Emerging with the kicking now. They're straight down the middle looking for O'Shea. He's unable to take the mark. Dean picks up and he's wrapped up in a good tackle and he's been pinged for holding the ball. So it's going to be...
He's kicked it.
Advantages.
Is he going to play the advantage? They have.
They have.
Wow.
So advantage was paid. And the goal there to Daniel Kennedy, who's brought the margin back to 1 point. Now 6-5-35. Ballarat 6-6-42. Western Region Football League. We've gone about 21 minutes. Second quarter.
I just didn't like that kick out, Kev. Straight down the corridor and we got outnumbered and I know it was a free kick against us, but it was the wrong option with that kick out then.
Yep.
It's
yep.
like they're playing, it's like there's a minute to go and they're 5 points down.
Yeah, no, not the smartest of options.
That was Joel Magnaposco with that kick out.
Look, and Paul O'Shea's got to be a bit stronger in those contests too, I reckon.
Armstrong Weston got the tap, but it came to Jared Gray and we got a kick inside 50, so it's already deep in Ballarat's forward half. The kick out of defence, though, by Prismal was good enough. Now back to Graham, though, was mown down in a tackle, sets it up to the top of the goal square. Prismal juggled, couldn't take the mark. Now Dean receives the hand pass, finds a little bit of space through the defensive 50, but turns it straight over. Well done there.
Jenkins.
By Jenkins to affect the contest, but he's given away a free kick, and Ballarat can work it through midfield now. The switch finds Daniel Kennedy, the goal kicker, a moment ago. Gives a hand pass back. Valet's got a kick towards. No communication from the Western Region defence. Two went up for the same mark and they both missed it.
He's been consistent playing that free kick.
But now they've won a free kick. Hand pass out the back. This is Graham. Chris Graham. Not much to go to. Just dances on the spot. Now pokes one across and fields it over. He was dealt with after he kicked it. And so Reece Miles will take the footy. Just backwards of centre wing on the Doug Hawkins side.
We were lucky with that free kick because we would have turned it over again.
And the temperature's gone up a notch at Witten Oval. There's a point the difference as we tick it a time on at the second quarter. That was a poor kick from Miles, but he receives the hand pass again, gives the hand pass over now to Quick.
No real movement.
And now working it through. They go laterally through the middle of the ground. That was a good kick, though. Through midfield, the hand pass finds Dean. It came from Magnaposco, and that's a good kick. And that's to Finko. Can he finish the job? No, that was always right. And
everything.
It slams into the behind post. So that is no score out on the full free kick Ballarat.
Toddy spent some time here on the VFL list for Footscray. Should know better than that.
He just had a bit more time there, Kev.
Yeah, he did.
Well, the wind is pushing every kick at goal to the right, whether you're kicking to either end of the ground today. The kick out wasn't great, though. Langlands gets the kick back inside the 50 at the back of the pack. Miles high up and under, centres it up. Underneath it is McDonald. Can he take the mark? He had the sit. Falls the way, though, of Castellano. He had it smothered. Gets it again on this one. Slams into the behind post again, this time the left-hand side. And so they're peppering the goals there the last few minutes. But nothing has come to fruition, and Ballarat can clear it out of defence.
So Ballarat clear now. They're out on the Dougie Hawkins wing. They've got a man in the space now. The handball over the top. He's running now. Kicks on his left boot inside 50. Looking again for Cupido. The ball doesn't reach him. Cupido does make up for it with a good tackle. Now the ball's coming to Graham.
Dropped it.
He's wrapped up. And we wait, and we'll have a ball up.
Gee, it's high octane now.
35 metres out from the Ballarat goal. We've gone about 23 minutes, second quarter. Ball's tossed up. Boyd with the hit out. But it's Kennedy for Ballarat.
Have it.
But now it's coming out through Ferrari. Clears well, done well. Handball it to Chris Graham. He runs out of defensive 50, goes long, looking for Bench. Bench has been dragged down there by Horbury, just inside.
Panicked.
The centre square. But this delay, it's given the chance for all the Ballarat defenders to push back now. So Bench from just inside the centre square.
Just got to be nice and calm here, spot the target, which
little
he's done.
Chip out wide. It's a good kick, finds Spiteri. Spiteri's looking for options.
There's no one leading for him.
Chips out wide. It's not a good kick. Mark is taken out there by Ballarat. They're looking for Jace Perkins again, but the kick was poor. Wasn't to his advantage. It's Ballarat now. With the long ball clearing on the outer side. Chris Graham is in front, almost tucked the mark. His second effort was great there. But the ball spilled there to Horbury. And now they're away here. Ballarat, as Horbury gets it again. Kicks with a bit of a check side mongrel kick, but it's going to go inside 50. Almost gets to Carey. But the handball there, but Sobelis chopped it off. Ball in dispute now. Quick handball. And it was a quick handball by Quick. Finds Dean. Running out halfback. Sorry, it was Spiteri now.
He's
looking for Spiteri. He's in space. And Spiteri on his left boot chips it over the top. And
it's again.
Easy mark taken there by Bench. But he was well worked on the mark by the Ballarat player there. Held him up. Bench is going to be moved around by the umpire. He's not even close to kicking over the man out of the mark.
Skills just weren't quite on enough to take advantage of that extra man they had
Perkins,
running forward.
Perkins was on then.
So Bench will kick from just inside 50. He comes in, kicks on its way. Looks all right.
Right off the boot.
If you don't mind, umpire.
Reece smiles there. With
I
a
think
crack.
Is it Perkins?
No, it's Perkins.
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 Yeah. Sorry, you're right. Yeah, Perkins with a great mark on the goal line there.
There's no one on the mark.
What's the point?
Yeah. Well, what a mark here by Perkins.
He kicked it.
You saw Travis Cloak miss one from there.
So Perkins gets his fourth, and it was a much, much needed goal for the Western Region Football League as they get the lead back out to 7 points. It's 7-6-48 to 6-5-41. 26 minutes gone, second quarter.
Halftime score from Manor Lakes and Caroline Springs. Manor Lakes 4 goals straight. Caroline Springs 24-4. 148. Kicked 13 goals for in that quarter. Haven't got stats on Sutton or Lake's contribution as yet.
So a much needed goal for the Western Region side. They absorbed plenty from Ballarat, who closed to within a point. It's back out to seven as Kennedy tried to get a kick away, was held onto. No free kick though.
He's played that one.
He's got one now for a high tackle. Just four to the centre circles. This is Steve Kennedy. Now the kick goes inside 50, just floating at the back. Taking the mark was Prismal.
This is where we've just got to be a bit more composure now. Coming towards time on.
It's good enough.
Looks like they're taking the game on again.
Brian Graham got the kick to Miles. Ducked around his opponent, now goes for a run. Bench was the target at right half forward, but he couldn't get it to him. It's fisted out of play. On the Doug Hawkins wing, about 70 metres around from Western Region's goal. 7-6, play 6-5.
You're under 19 boys behaving themselves on the back of that big win, Smackers.
Yeah, it looks like it. A couple of soft drinks in their hand.
Jeez, the bar must be dry.
Kennedy was in there again. Just found a way out, and then Miles pumped it forward underneath it. Couldn't quite take the mark. Crumbing beautifully was Jenkins, and now off the footy. Surely that's holding the man, and it is.
Magna Bosco
is going to take the free kick from about 35 out right in front.
That guy was Timmy Jenkins there.
Yeah, he did the old Timmy Watson, didn't he?
He did, didn't he? He jumped over the bloke in front of him mid-air and hand-passed it out.
He got up for a little fella too.
He's a beauty, Timmy Jenkins.
And these are all important shots at goal. As we near half-time, Magna Bosco.
Good kick.
Yeah,
it was tight to the line.
No, it's a goal. Come on.
umpires are confirmed.
You haven't got any TV cameras. Just make your mind up.
We're pretty sure it's a goal from up here.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Fooled. Touched on the line and Ballarat will run it out. 7-7 to 6-5, 8 points the lead. And now they can go the overlap on the outer side of the ground. That was a poor kick, though.
Well done, Mills.
Chopped
Mills.
Off by Jeremy Mills. He took the mark, but that kick was iffy. Oh. Gee, that's a good mark from Finko if it's paid. No.
What?
It's going to go the way of Ballarat. Surely he had front position.
I thought so.
Anyway, the umpire's right there, so we'll back him in. The kick goes towards right half forward. Taking it out in front was McAuliffe. Got the hand pass over the top. Banner. That's a good kick. And it'll be marked by Pring. It was knocked away from him at the last moment, but it's paid. And from the right forward pocket, about 45 out, we are right behind him here.
Wouldn't mind seeing that Magna Bosco goal again, because I reckon the umpire was standing behind the Ballarat bloke as opposed to where he probably should have been, which was on the line.
This one is not going to bend back enough. It's not even going to make the distance. And it's slapped through for a rush behind.
This is where we've just got to control the footy, but we're going quick again.
That's
and
Timmy should have grabbed it. He'll run around
Jenkins
this way.
From the kick in.
He's got no one to kick to. Hey,
plenty of speed.
He had to go backwards.
And then Brian Graham offered a reprieve backwards in the right back pocket. He goes short. Tim Quick takes the mark. So now they decide to poke it around a little bit.
This is better.
Miffy little kick though. Ryan in plenty of space takes the mark. So they've worked it all the way to the right half back and now back into the left back pocket. Pokes one over the top. Mills flew over the top of O'Shea. Neither could take the mark and it's out of bounds. So Ballarat can reset and try and go forward and maybe manufacture a last gasp goal. Not sure how long this quarter's going to go for. The last went for 33. Unlikely to see one go that length again. So they're thrown in.
Good hands.
Well done by Mills. Got a hand pass away. Now Dean through midfield. Had Miles. Went to go himself. The kick looking for Finko. Tough stuff from Finko, but they break away. And Hind again finding some space. That's a good kick out in front of his teammate in McAuliffe. Overran it though. Now Pring in some space. Sends one up. There's
Josh.
Two against him. Well done by Bench. And now Western Region somehow had no right to clear that out, and the Ballarat side probably had a right to goal, but they couldn't do it. Miles through heavy traffic, couldn't find a teammate. Notman had it, and they work it backwards again. Kennedy, that's Daniel, spearing pass
down,
inside 50. And now with ball in hand is Jeremy Mills. 29 and a half gone. That was an iffy kick. And now fisted forward, still inside 50 for Ballarat, trying to work it out. Bench.
And
that was a smart kick out wide. Dean took it left half back and poked one out in front. Armstrong Weston was muscled out of it by Buckwell though. And now Jared Graham spears one inside the centre square. And Tung takes the mark. Just going patiently now, lowers the eyes. It's not a bad kick, but it's had a little bit too much on it for Valais. And the mark's taken by Ferrari. Short to Graham. It wasn't his best effort. Oh, no. Goodness me. Sablich surely should have taken the mark, but affecting it there was Pring. Western Region trying to find a way out of defence. Matty Ryan diving. Takes the mark just inside the field of play. And then pokes one over the top to Spiteri, who hangs in the air and clutches it.
Spiteri now squares it, looking for Boyd, who marks.
Handball. Boys out there.
Handball to Brian Graham. Goes out wide. The Dougie Hawker's been handball back inside. Now comes to Prismal on his left boot. Goes long inside 50, looking for O'Shea, who's dragged to ground.
Play
the
on.
Free kick's paid.
Miles take it back.
Took the advantage. luckily, the umpire didn't call the advantage because he missed, and now the free kick's going to go to O'Shea, and he'll kick for about 40 metres out.
Working hard, Paul O'Shea. He was back in that back line, almost a centre-half back there for about 3 or 4 minutes with about 3 or 4 hand passes. Now he's worked his way down the ground having this shot at goal, so it's good to see that.
Well, that's what you need, Kevy. He hasn't really had a big influence, so he's got to get involved, and obviously he's got good endurance in that, so he's got to use that to his advantage.
So we've gone about 33 minutes here in the second quarter again.
Wow.
So free kick to O'Shea. Now he's coming off with a blood rule now. So O'Shea's coming off. Can't pick who's got the taking the kick now. That's Reese. Prisma's got the kick for the Western Region Football League now.
Prisma's the back man.
He's on his left foot, left side, Kev,
yeah,
so
no,
it should,
all right.
Be, should be on a...
So Prisma, interchange has been made.
Perkins came on. So if this
get in
falls
the goal
short,
square, Perk.
Yep.
Take another hanger. So wait for Prisma.
No barracking, please.
Oh. How smack is that?
A bit late for that, bit late for that, Pep. Yeah. Been doing it since the first bounce.
Yeah. So Frizzle comes in, kicks on its way. Oh, he's hooked it to the right for one behind. So scores now 7-8, 50 to 6-6, 42. 8-point lead to the Western Region Football League.
Get back in the men's department where you belong.
With a bounce through the defensive 50 comes Ballarat. Oh, flying through the air was Graham. He almost dragged down a miraculous mark, but it's going to come out the back, and they've got spare men inside 50, and it was just a quick kick, and McAuliffe takes the mark, 40 from goal, right in front. Oh, and he's got Spud Graham running in, and he's going to waltz in from about 15 out, and can he draw Ballarat within 2 points? He does. He got very close to the bloke in front of him, though. It could have been smothered, but he did enough. Jared Graham, 7-6-48. His side now, 2 points closer.
It's just
to
too
Western
easy,
region.
Them, wasn't it? And their forward line's open, and they're on the move, and they're playing in front. So that's a difference at the moment going forward.
7 goals apiece now, just a couple of behinds separating them. Surely on the brink of half time. Nearing the 34th minute.
There's a free kick. Yeah,
free kick. Bench got sprung, caught in the centre square there.
Sortino got the hand pass back. Horbury went out wide, and the mark's taken by Valet. Centre wing, Doug Hawkins' side pumps one towards full forward. Bench is in front, but he heard the voice and allowed Murray Boyd to just float in and take an uncontested mark. So they've just got to hold on to this. Can't afford to fall behind at half time. Again, they crash the pack. Ballarat, seemingly with the numbers. Oh, diving in over the top was Pring. Might have got it over the shoulder. He did.
Goes all right there, Pring.
It's been good. Kicked one this afternoon, Pring.
Oh, no.
Short pass. Gee, that was poor. It was off a step, and the mark's taken by Carey. Can go back inside the 50, spills the mark, and at the back of the pack, can he curl it through? No. It was Lucas Anderson with ball in hand for Ballarat, and he had a chance to put them in front.
What was Joshy McDonald thinking there with that little pokey left foot kick? Just a poor decision.
Both sides,
no momentum behind
the highlights reel then was out the window.
Well, still working it through Western Region, still inside defensive 50. Ryan got the kick out wide, trying to juggle a mark there for Ballarat, but unable to. Bench ends up with it, darts around a couple of players, gives the hand pass over the top. Might have been Perkins. Now Western Region move it towards half forward, through the middle of the ground.
Come on, Josh
McDonald,
hit a target.
Just needs to poke one inside 50 and diving forward.
It's a bit of a little left foot pokey kick.
Much better. This is it. And it was perfectly timed.
It's Panay, I think.
Panay, yeah.
Yeah. He likes these ones. He's a goal kicker. He's a noted goal kicker for Werribee Districts.
Oh, Panay.
Big boardy running down. Kev, the Ballarat boys have got 5 in the square. Now our boys have realised.
Yeah, boardy's gone in there with Weston Young. Armstrong, Western, sorry.
From 40 out right in front for a 7-point lead at the main break. That's hooking left. That one has not registered a score. So it's half time here at Witten Oval, and well, it's about as close as you'd care to like it if you're a Western Region fan. 1 point is the lead after they were led at one stage by 34 points, kicking the first three of the quarter into the breeze. But Ballarat have fought back valiantly. Goal scorers in the opening half. Chase Perkins leads the way for the home side. He's got four singles to Murray Boyd, Brian Graham and Daniel Castellano. While